There's a new certification out for Azure Cosmos DB. Learn all about it and how to prep for the exam this week on Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, we have Mustafa Brandt from the Cosmos DB team. Mustafa, thanks so much for joining us today. Can you tell us a little bit about what you do?
Yeah, thanks for having me. Happy to be here. So my name is Mustafa Branch. I'm the portfolio PMM for Azure Cosmos DB. As far as what that role requires, it tends to be a lot of different things, but mainly I'm focused on creating content and messaging for the implementer audience.
Okay, cool. Awesome. And I know you have a couple series I was just watching. They're really awesome. So we'll be sure to put that in the description. But today we're going to be talking about some new stuff. But for folks who might not have heard of Cosmos DB, I thought it might be nice if you could start by telling us a little bit about what is Cosmos DB.
Yeah, I'm sure. So Azure Cosmos DB is Azure's fast, horizontally scaling NoSQL database offering. We have multiple database APIs that support multiple NoSQL models, such as document model, the graph model, the key value model, and column-wide model. There's no enforced schema, which is something that's really important about our database. That kind of means your database can evolve as your application needs evolve. And that's not something that's typically the same in a relational database. And to cover the full spectrum of pricing, as well as the needs of different size apps, large and small, we also have a really great free tier offering, a really cost-effective consumption-based serverless offering, and an auto-scaling provision throughput offering.
Awesome. Cool. Yeah, it seems like a great place for building new apps, especially when you need this scaling or you're just getting started and you need something free. So awesome all around. Now, as people kind of get up to speed on using Cosmos DB or other services in Azure or Microsoft for that matter, a lot of times there are like certifications so you can prove that you're good and qualified to work with these types of products. I think there's a new certification. Can you tell us a little bit about it?
Yeah, so we have a new certification that's scheduled for GA in March. It's called the Azure Cosmos DB Developer Specialty Certification. And there's also a certification for data engineers. And so that certification basically covers relational databases for the most part. And we found that the NoSQL skill set was really a need that we needed to address more directly with more narrow scope certification. And so with this one, we focus on Cosmos DB specifically. It covers everything you need to know from like modeling, partitioning, all the way up to optimization and monitoring. And it's really there to lay the groundwork for some of those foundational and key concepts that partners and implementers felt like they might have been missing, especially when coming from a relational setting.
Gotcha. Makes sense. And for myself personally, like I think exams are a great way to kind of push myself to learn something. So, you know, this is a great way to do that with Azure Cosmos DB. Along those lines, like, are there certain resources that you might recommend for people that are going to try to take this exam and become Azure Cosmos DB experts?
Yeah. So in creating the certification, and I think the exam's official title is DP420, our engineering team put together a whole swath of new learning modules. And so if you go to one of the links in the description, there's actually a MS Learn collection with all the new modules in it. That's a really great place to start. Wow. Additionally, one of our awesome cloud advocates, Thomas Moore, put together a pretty great study guide that people can follow as well. And so both those things are in the description. They're great resources.
Awesome. That's awesome. You know, we promote Microsoft Learn a lot on this show because it has so many great resources and it takes you step by step. And a lot of times you get hands-on. So it's awesome to hear you kind of brought all the things you need into Microsoft Learn, as well as these tips and tricks. What about if you're just getting started with NoSQL? Like on this show and in general, a lot of people are talking about relational databases or SQL type databases. What if you're, you know, starting this journey, you want to explore NoSQL, you want to learn about it, you know, how can people get started?
Yeah, so a great resource to get started is actually a series we've been working on called the Azure Cosmos DB Essentials series. If you really have no experience in NoSQL, that's usually a great place to start because it'll explain like what it is, what are the use cases. It'll break down some of the topics like request units and how we think about those in Cosmos DB. It'll explain the APIs. And so that's a really great format if you consume things in on video a lot better than you do maybe reading them. And then we also have another resource, a podcast ran by one of our PMs, Mark Brown. In that podcast, he deep dives into some of the more technical topics. He'll focus on specific topics like Synapse Link. He'll have other PMs and guests on to deep dive into maybe products that are built on Cosmos DB, as well as some feature level explanations from the PMs working on them. So that's a pretty great resource to hear some of the learning content direct from the people who built it.
Awesome. Yeah, I love it. And Mark Brown's great. I love the podcast, so I'm glad we're promoting it here. I also just checked out your series, the Azure Cosmos DB for Beginners, and it is awesome. It is so well done. I think it's going to be really useful for people. So definitely encourage folks to check it out. Hey, as we wrap the show up, Mustafa, do you have any final tips or tricks or advice for people either getting started with Cosmos DB or getting started to prepare for this exam?
Yeah, so I'd say for people who are just getting started, one place they can start is the product page. There's some links to try free, as well as some other descriptions of NoSQL. But I'd say the most important thing is to just jump right in and get learning. And so MS Learn's a great place for that. You can maybe start with one module like modeling or partitioning, or getting started with Cosmos DB. And from there, it's just kind of a day-by-day process.
I love it. Yeah, always learning. And there's tons of great resources. So thanks so much, Mustafa, for coming on the show. This was useful for myself. I've got some things to go check out, and I think our viewers will as well. To our viewers, be sure to check the links in the description for everything you need to know to get started with Azure Cosmos DB. If you like this video, go ahead and give it a like, comment, and let us know what you think of the certification. And we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.